Devoted is a creative novel written by Dean Koontz as has some terrible, great, and monstrous components. The storyline will make you guessing on each page. This transhumanist plotline has a few interfacing storylines loaded up with clear characters you'll either cherish or despise. Lots of clashing intentions. The advanced technology and science fiction components are generally conceivable but disconcerting enough to make this a dramatic thriller. He sets good against bad and folds the story over an adoring and lovely dog. In this story we have a mildly autistic pre-teenager named Woody. He was created brilliantly by Koontz. He's quiet, not because he actually can't talk but since he fears communicating in the incorrect manner. His mom is a skilled craftsman on her way up in the art world. His dad died in a tragic accident that Woody is profoundly dubious of and feels his dad was killed. The villain is a rich and evil person who once charmed his mom. He committed a heinous crime that killed numerous people in a research center, and when the story opens he headed to Costa Rica to hang out and carry on with the luxurious way of life he thinks he merits. He is intent to have his old love interest, Woody's mom, go along with him. He is determined to get this going despite the fact that she has just negative recollections and sentiments towards him. The story unfolds itself with the two groups, mother and kid on one side set in opposition to a man with no ethical compass or empathy on the other. And afterward, obviously, enters the dog. What a dog it is. Koontz hits a grand slam with this book by doing what he specializes in. Keeping the readers turning the pages. One of my issues with Devoted is the measure of characters that we are acquainted with. It's not generally what I had expected from Koontz. In spite of the fact that I get that Devoted is to a great extent a sci-fi novel and anything can pretty much occur inside its pages, yet some of it was very difficult for me to get my head around. My other issue was the character Lee Shackett. I think some of the scenes were both superfluous and undesirable from a reader's viewpoint. I appreciated the real plotline and the street that Koontz was endeavoring to go down with Shackett, yet I don't feel that the execution was nailed. Being in this individual head was amazingly terrible. As a seasoned reader of thrillers, I have come to realize what goes on in a mental case's head, yet we don't have to know each debased idea. If the writer had cut in excess of a couple of his sections, the Devoted would have moved along at a more ideal speed.